Hello all, this is Sanad Malaysia speaking. I would like to present you our overview paper for the shared task ARAFIN NLP 2024, the first Arabic financial NLP shared task. My colleagues in this work are Mahmoud Al-Haj, Saad Al-Zaini, Muhammad Khaliliya, Mustafa Jarrar, Sultan Al-Mujawil, Ismail Barrada, and Huda O. Umar. Before starting the presentation, please allow me to announce our resources at SinaLab, which you may visit at this link and download all our datasets, including this shared task dataset, which is called RBanking 77. Also, you can scan this QR code for faster access to the resources. This shared task consists of two subtasks. The first one is the multi-dialect intent detection, where the participant will receive the queries of the customers in the banking domain in different dialects, Arabic dialects, and he have to classify them into one or many of commonly known 77 intents in the banking domain, while the other task is the cross-dialect translation and intent preservation. The participant here will receive the MSA query and he has to translate it into multi other Arabic dialects, taking into consideration to preserve the original intent in the MSA query. Let's take these figures as illustration. For example, in subtask 1, the first figure at the top, we can see that there are four queries in different dialects that are matching one intent, which is تم تحصيل رسوم الدفع بالبطاقة, or the corresponding translation for it, card payment fee charged. However, the participant will not know each query to which dialect belong. That's what will make the task more complicated and challengeable. While in the second figure at the bottom, we can see that the input is the MSA query, which is ما هي رسوم الدفع على بطاقتي, and the participant should translate it to the other four dialects that are covered in the shared task, which are the Palestinian, Saudi, Moroccan, and Tunisian. And we can see here how is it very complicated to translate each word in the different dialects, because for example, let's say the first word, Mahia, in the Palestinian, translated as Shu, while in Saudi, Wish, in Moroccan, Shnu, and in Tunisian, Shinwa. Another word, the Al-Bitaka, or Bitakati, translated into Bitaka in most dialects, okay? But in Tunisian, is translated into Karta, and so on. The dataset that is used for this shared task is RBanking 77, which consists of around 39,000 queries. At beginning, we shared with the participants the training and development splits of the MSA and Palestinian. However, we kept all the test data for the evaluation phase, which consists of the four dialects that will be evaluated based on. And in the figure, we can see the distribution of these dialects in the dataset. 45 teams who registered for the shared task and requested for the data, but only 11 teams participated at the final stages and submitted their results into CodeLab platform. All the 11 teams participated in subtask 1, but only one of them participated in subtask 2. The metric used in subtask 1 is F1 score, and we see the range between almost 50% to 88% approximately. However, the metric used for subtask 2 is blue, and the only team participated in it achieved 1.667. We have diverse models and techniques used in this shared task, starting from the transformer-based models such as BERT and T5, moving to the deep learning approaches using LSTM variants, and ending with the traditional machine learning techniques such as support vector machine and TF-IDF. However, the transformer-based methods achieved the best, and we can see at the top the team who used the ensemble of fine-tuned BERT-based models achieved the best by augmenting the data set with additional data. And the second team also used MARBERT, GARIP, which are also BERT-based models. Third team is T5, and we can see that it ends with the final teams using, let's say, traditional techniques, methods, and tools. Then, this shared task is still challengeable because we need to collect and annotate more data to cover the Arabic dialectal variations across the different regions. We need to, let's say, build tailored and dedicated models that serve the complex communications in the Arabic financial and banking domain. However, still, we need to see more innovative techniques and solutions. Thank you all for listening. Please approach me if you have any questions.